What do these big cats and these salamanders have in common? It's a fascinating phenomenon in nature. I am Koa, and this is Koa Nature's Casual Outdoors Weekly. And recently I was out doing some herping. And let me clear up what herping is real quick, because the last time I was explaining to someone what herping was, she thought that I was going to nightclubs trying to pick up women infected with herpes. No, that's not what herping is. First off, that's wrong because I don't ever spend any time trying to find women, only animals. And that sounds really sad now that I've said it out loud. Moving on. The word herping is derivative of the word herpetology, which is the zoological field of study pertaining to amphibians and reptiles and their relatives. Ergo, I was not in the woods herping trying to find women, I was in the woods herping to find snakes and frogs and salamanders. And my friend Caesar, who is a reptile enthusiast, was also with me that day. And we came across a number of cool specimens of various species, as we often do.
Another yellow one, and there's a nice dog coming by.
Big dog?
Yeah, hello doggy.
Floof. Hey, floof.
Hi doggy. We're hunting salamanders. We're herping.
But on this day, I was out searching for a specific species that had a special feature. And I was so excited because not only did we find a bunch of specimens, but I also found three different morphs of the species I was looking for, all under the exact same log. Yes, each one of these salamanders is the same species, the Eastern Redback Salamander. They have different appearances, just like the two leopards seen here, that are the same species but obviously appear quite different. So this week we're going to explore this cool animal polymorphism. So yes, this is an example of polymorphism, or the occurrence of two or more different phenotypes, sometimes referred to as different morphs or phases, in an interbreeding population. These morphs show different colors in their skin pigmentation. The Eastern Redback Salamander is typically found with a reddish stripe along its back. It is also common to find the Eastern Redback Salamander with no visible stripe in its lead-backed morph. Technically, we call this an anerythristic specimen because it is lacking red pigmentation. We can also see the yellow-striped morph, where we technically call this a xanthochroistic or xanthic morph, as yellow has replaced the red pigmentation. And these stripes can actually vary greatly in color on the Eastern Redback Salamander, from red to orange to yellow and even to white. But I'm yet to ever find a white-backed specimen. And keep in mind that these morphs are not resulting from new mutations in the DNA. Rather, these colors are resulting from heritable alleles or variant genes that exist and have existed within these populations for a long time. In most places within northeastern North America where this salamander is found, the red-striped phenotype is represented more than the other phenotypes in most populations, probably because of a dominant allele or multiple alleles. But in some localized populations, the lead-backed phase is more often seen than the red-striped phase. And on occasion, you can find a redback salamander that is entirely red, or what we would call erythristic. But I have a feeling that this wouldn't count as a polymorphism, like the other colors of the redback morph or the leadback morph, because an all-red salamander is probably all red because of a new mutation, and so that heritable frequency is too low to count as a polymorphism. Polymorphic traits are sustained in a population because they are favorable for adaptive evolution that allows the genes to be passed on in varying environmental conditions. In other words, having different morphs has been a successful evolutionary strategy for this species. And polymorphism includes what we see in species exhibiting sexual dimorphism, where there are phenotypic differences between males and females. And polymorphic traits can extend beyond external features, such as the different phenotypes seen in human blood groups, where a blood type is classified based on the absence or presence of different antibodies and antigens on red blood cells. I can't express how amazed and thrilled I was to see three different morphs under the same log. That was the first time for me. I'm actually just probably going to post that clip raw on YouTube because it just needs to be there. Subscribing is free. Spread some knowledge. Be nature heroic. And I'm still probably not going to spend any of my free time looking for a date because there are just so many amazing things in nature that need to be researched and observed. Cheers.